I said coffee.
Beer.
Coffee.
B-E-A.
C-O.
B-A.
What? No. No. What? No. What? You went into the attic? I'm very disappointed and terrified. Why don't you bring this potato? It's pretty big.
Mom, you're always trying to give me potatoes. What is it with you?
I just think they're neat. Why do birds suddenly appear over there, over here? 8 spices. Some must be doubles. Oregano. What the hell? Oh, no, not Lenny. Not Lenny. Kids, turn off the TV. I have some bad news about Lenny.
Not Lenny!
Hi. How's it going, everybody? We got an opener still. Let's do this real quick.
I gotta take you back.
Next on Jelly Roll Chicago, Film Stuffs So Far, a monthly short film program featuring guests of Film Stuffs Live. This week, Volume 1, Lucas Guy Taylor and Christian Gridelli. Hosted by Jake S. Weisman, produced by the original Boz Scaggs, Jack Quint. Live on YouTube, Twitch, and Facebook. Enjoy the program.
What's happening, film dorks? Jake S. Weisman here. Thanks for joining us. What is this episode? Why did I just look like a deer in headlights just then? When we rewatch this, that's going to be hysterical. What is this show? We're doing film stuff so far. No guests. It's just me and Jack and going through some of the work from the guests that we've had over the past month. What a great idea. I not just talking to these artists, but also watching their work so you can go back and maybe everything will be a lot more fun. Jack, oh, Jack. Jack, where are you, Jack?
Oh, hello there, Jake.
How you doing, guy?
Oh, you know, I had a little bit of a freak out when you're like, oh, no, we have an opener. I'm like, oh, that's what that clip was. So, yeah, good producing on my part. Good cueing and making sure that all the things are in the right place. So, yeah.
Oh, your producer's
doing a top-notch job here.
Well, I've heard that it's kind of been a day. Oh, look at this.
Look who's joining you in the captain's chair.
That's exciting. I begged him earlier to come join me.
Nice.
Jack, how you doing, buddy?
I'm doing all right. Looks like, we have some fun guests in the audience tonight.
We have
Amber LeMay watching
tonight.
Amber
LeMay is the best.
And I just want you all to know that Amber was kind of the reason that we're doing this show right now. This is sort of a spinoff from that. And in case you don't know, Amber LeMay is, I think, Vermont's favorite drag queen. I think it's safe to say that.
I think that's pretty fair.
And every Sunday night, Amber hosts a talk show kind of like this, with all sorts of guests on, not just locals from Vermont, but people from all over the country and all over the world. People who are in entertainment, people who are politicians, and it's a lot of fun. This coming week, we've got Francois Clemens, better known as Officer Clemens from Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood.
That's so exciting.
Yeah, and he's a repeat guest, so this is his third time on the show. And you can check them out.
How come I've only been on once?
We had to book you way out in advance. We booked you way out to get that interview.
You were a very busy man. And come onto the show again.
We had to pay you twice as much what we pay all the other guests.
I'm a pretty good get.
Yeah.
Hey.
So that's on Sunday nights at 8:00. You can watch on, just like here, Facebook, Twitch, YouTube. Oh, and while you're at it, we should mention that if you watch on YouTube, you get to see the program in high def. So
it's
in the full 1080 HD rather than 720 bit. So while you're at it, like, share, and subscribe. Go to jellyrollchicago.com. Like us, share us.
You guys make it seem like Amber Live is just one day a week, but it's more than one day a week.
It is more than one
day a week.
Oh, no.
Am I nuts here? Am I losing my damn mind?
Not about that, anyway. The Amber Live show is on it's on Sunday nights at 8 o'clock. There's also an Amber Chat every Wednesday. It's a little bit more freeform. That's Wednesday's usually about 8. We're a little bit loose on the start time, but it's a lot of fun. And just like with this, you can send in your questions. You could even be a guest if you want. So let us know if you'd like to be a guest or you have comments, and we'll get your opinion and your voice heard. Cool. Let us know.
Well, enough talking about Amber. They're not paying me enough, so
I tell them that every week.
I'm really excited about today. Hi, Mom. How you doing, Mama? I'm learning how to schedule right now, and I'm not particularly great at it. So
skill.
I know, right? And so I'm learning in real time. Which is kind of one of the reasons why we're doing a showcase, not just because I didn't want to scramble to like find a buddy who could hang out.
The check's in the mail.
It best be, because I haven't seen sent one Amber.
Yeah, it's next to the Venmo from Matt Gaetz.
Gross.
It's disgusting.
We're going to bleep that name out later.
So continuing, you're learning how to schedule in real time.
And
What's that like?
It's stressful, but I'm getting better at it, I think. And so May is coming together really nicely. But I figured we're going to make lemons out of lemonade. Is that the saying?
No.
We're going to make prunes out of prune juice.
Nobody says that.
So much to do. What is this? So little to do and so much time to do it in.
They say that.
this idea of like, how about we take the month's guests and show their work instead of just showing clips and stuff? You can watch a proper short by the people that came. And then if you happen across this show and you like the short that you watched, go back, watch that interview if you haven't yet. And I thought that was cool. And Christian Gridelli and Lucas Guy Taylor gave me permission to show their work. How about
that?
I know.
You know what that kind of reminds me of?
Tell me.
Television.
What?
In a way, it reminds me of television, because once upon a time, TV just used to do this thing where it would play stuff like movies, and you would just be pleasantly surprised to walk in on it rather than knowing ahead of time all the things that you could just spend hours that you could watch just scrolling through that menu.
For what it's worth, that is one of my goals with this show, is to make a 24-hour YouTube channel where I take all the interviews, all of our shorts, all of our features, and just have it going 24 hours on YouTube as an independent film channel, because Lord knows we can't stay on Amazon, Jack. We don't have a home at Amazon anymore.
Well, see, you've got the scheduling thing down. You at least have a plan, but this is bad news about the Amazon. Let's talk a little bit about that.
So if you were paying, if you hung out with us last week, is what I'm trying to say. If you hung out with us last week, me and Christian and Jack talked about how My Movie Scrapers, you cannot stream for free on Amazon Prime anymore, which is a major bummer for me, and felt like a blow. Also, we spent like a long time looking at both sides of that argument and why Amazon is deciding right now, like, maybe we should charge rent to like have content up and stop giving stuff away. In the week, Christian's movie is not available to stream. Luke hit me up this morning. Lucas Guy Taylor hit me up this morning, said Break and our short Winnie and Charlotte are not available free to stream. In fact, I asked Luke for a comment and he sent this. Do we have it?
Yes.
1 second. Let me show you.
Here it is.
I'll just kill myself.
No, don't do that, Jonah.
I know.
Jonah,
I gotta
it
end it.
Don't do that.
I'm
stuck. Oh, hey, come on. No, don't. Would you put the thing down?
I'm trying to have some fun,
okay,
man.
Yeah, this is great.
I understand where he's coming from, to be perfectly frank with you.
So is there a direct correlation with their movies getting taken down and our show? I mean, Were we the kiss of death?
I don't think we're the kiss of death. I think we're the only ones talking about it. I haven't seen any article about it. I would love to see. You know what I saw was someone did a YouTube video recently that said, I didn't even know this existed, but they're like, Amazon is going to stop. There was a program where you could upload your movie and they would sell it as a DVD, like a physical copy
of
it.
No kidding.
No kidding. Wow. And they're like, they're not going to do it anymore. And I'm like, no shit, they're not going to do it anymore. Like, that sounds expensive. What they want me to do
to have
is
a physical
expensive.
Copy of it. Yeah.
So, but no one's talking about how this is, but we have a guest coming up in a couple of weeks. And last week, their movie was available for free. This week, it's not. Everyone's movie got taken off.
Wow.
Everyone's movie got taken off. And like I don't know.
Indie filmmakers.
Yeah, like I don't know what the story is. According to the email that they sent me, it's, you know, we weren't getting enough traffic. I don't know if there are indie shows that are getting that kind of traffic. But well,
with that in mind, if you are an indie filmmaker out there and if you have had your film taken down from Amazon, we would like to know your story about that.
Yeah.
And similarly, if you know somebody who has that kind of situation, let us know about that. This is a great beginning of this story, and this is how we talk about this sort of thing.
Right. Or if there's any articles or you see any videos or anything like that, shoot them our way. Because I don't know anyone else who's talking about this. And this is as far as I'm concerned, this is the independent film news.
So like Amber says that the LeMay movie is still up for rent and for sale.
Is it for free though?
Right. That is the question. So was Slingbacks and Syrup available for free via Prime? I don't know that it was.
All of our movies are still there. You can purchase Scrapers for $3.99, right? Plus tax or something.
Let me check this out.
We talked about it last week. It's kind of the kiss of death. I'm not sure.
Slingbacks and Syrup is available to rent for $1 with Prime.
And that's the thing is, if they're starting to do this, I don't know at what point they're going to say, listen, now your movie's just taking up space. No one's watching it. Where people were watching it a little bit before, now nobody's watching it. Get the hell off the platform. Yeah, get the hell off the platform. And I kind of can see it going that way. But right now, all of our stuff is still there. Our work is there. So if you want to support us, like I'll be buying those movies for the guests coming up, because I really want to watch these movies and I, you know, it makes sense to watch them. And I'm not going to sit here and not watch them because it's not streaming, but it's a damn shame, a damn shame. And that's another reason why I wanted to. So are they just getting rid of the
free streaming things? So Scrapers was available to stream online for free.
If you have an Amazon Prime membership.
And that was the case with these other films that we're talking about.
Yep. Origins of Wit and Humor, Break, right. Bugs a Trilogy. So I don't know. How long this is going to stay. And
I think that there's
going to champion us.
Yeah, I think that there is some validity to the argument that they were making from their side, that saying we've had your content up. We think that somebody should put forward some sort of a cost. I think they can make that claim if they're not Amazon, if they're not, you know, the top company in the world.
If I was Jeff Bezos, I'd probably tell me to go screw off, right? Like, maybe. But also, I think all it takes is like one or two champions to be like, I want to host independent films. And that is something we're trying to do on our show on our own very tiny little way, which is what this show is, a place to watch Winnie and Charlotte for free if you want, along with other things, because Prime's not doing it anymore. And that's a bummer, man. That's a bummer. So before we get into the shorts program, we're going to start real soon. I do want to make this general blanket announcement. We're not Netflix, we're not Prime, we're not Disney Plus. So the way our servers work, I can only upload a certain sized video. I can only upload a video that looks a certain way for me to be able to stream it to your living room. So if you excuse me, if you enjoy these films and you think, man, I want the highest resolution, I want the brightest color, please go to dimestorefilms.com. Please go to bbfprods.com. Watch these movies. Go where you can. Go to, they have movies on YouTube. They have movies on their Vimeo. Their website should link you to them. Watch the beautiful version. I just want to get this to you. And this is the best way I can do it right now on my budget. So if you want to join our Patreon so I can buy my own server, let's start doing that. You can Venmo me so I can start, me and Jack, our own independent film server right here on the internet.
This is how it's done.
This is how it begins, mon frere.
We are addressing that there is a problem, and we are putting forward solutions to this problem, but we cannot do it without you. This is like the NPR drive.
It's literally the exact same thing. I'm Ira Glass. I'm Ira Glass, Jack.
Oh, you get to be Ira Glass? Okay, fine.
No, I don't know. I can. I don't know who anyone else. That's
Terry Gross, and I don't want to be Terry Gross.
Okay, I'll be Terry Gross. So first, we're going to watch three shorts by BBF Productions. That's Lucas Guy Taylor and Marissa Lessman. We're going to watch Captain's Chair, Close, and Winnie and Charlotte. I actually have something to do with all three of those, and we can talk a little bit in between. I wrote Captain's Chair. And I shot and edited Close, and I star in Winnie and Charlotte. Ooh. And then we will go into Dime Store Films work. And that'll be fun because we start with a comedy and end with, I guess it's a drama. Really interesting story. So you get to
what
see
an
some
arc.
Cool. You get to see some cool arc. That's all I'm saying.
I like a good arc.
And then maybe we'll have a treat at the end, Jack, maybe. I don't know.
We shall see.
We'll see what happens.
We'll see what happens.
All right. So without further ado, Jack, this has been a joy. Let's watch Captain's Chair.
And away we go. Smoke 'em if you got 'em.
Peach, I need some advice. Can I ask you something?
Of course.
There's a boy I like, and I'm not sure if I should ask him out.
Ah. Not me.
Not you.
Very good.
Well.
In times like these, I like to turn to the captains.
What does that mean?
Well, there's four schools of thought. Some say six, some even say seven with the new timeline, but for me, it will always be four.
The schools of thought?
Yes. Kirk would say, go for it. Grab him by the waist, give him a big smooch. He'll know your intentions.
That seems a little forward.
A little 10 forward? You know, if you actually watched the show, you'd be in hysterics right now.
Color me hysterical.
Now, Picard. Oh, Picard. He would take a more nuanced approach.
Now we're talking.
He would observe the situation from every conceivable angle. And then, he'd make his decision. And he'd stick with it. Of course, the same could be said for Sisko. Oh, but Sisko has heart. You know, there's a warmth to Sisko that Picard sometimes hides. Yeah, Picard, he's married to the job.
We're getting further away from useful advice, Beach.
Sisko's a family man. He has a kid. You know, he has a firm hand, but a sweet side. The same could be said of certain friends sitting on certain couches next to me.
Go on.
Sisko has a temper. When Picard gets angry, he's very reserved. But when Sisko gets pissed, he punches Q right in the face. But Sisko shows his emotions. Whereas Picard, he comes off as a little cold.
Oh, well, we don't want that.
Never. Now, the fourth way, that's the Jane way. She's a science officer and captain of Starfleet's latest and greatest starship. She has Sisko's warmth, Picard's intellect, Kirk's tenacity. She's brilliant, she's kind, and she's stubborn, but in the best possible way.
Well, what would Janeway say about my situation?
Ask him out, but do it with a big smile on your face. And if he says no, well, then you laugh, because you're the greatest captain Starfleet has to offer.
Thanks, Beach. That's just what I needed to hear.
Good luck. Energize.
I don't know what that blinking was, but still pretty cool.
Isn't that a Star Trek thing?
It wasn't intentional. I love Star Trek, though. I don't know if you know.
I think I've heard it once or twice.
Especially Voyager. There's some good stuff in there.
I know that you are very much a Picard sort of guy. You know, did you know that I have been, of course you know, I've been to the future birthplace of James Tiberius Kirk.
You got me in trouble once.
I did. When I was visiting you in Chicago, I took a little trip out to Riverside, Iowa, went to this barbershop there, and then behind it, there's a little stone memorial that says this is the future birthplace of James Tiberius Kirk.
That's unbelievable.
Unbelievable is a good word to describe the experience.
For anyone just joining us, we're watching some shorts.
Oh, we do have some people just joining us.
Hi.
Hello. Hi, Mom.
Hey, Mom.
And Gigi says that she loves Captain's Chair.
I'm a fan of Captain's Chair myself.
Amber wants to know if you have been to the Enterprise set. That is a thing in, where is that? Ticonderoga, right?
Oh.
It's across from Lake Champlain.
I don't know. Not that one. When there was a Vegas Star Trek experience, my mother took me to Las Vegas because I was 17. And my mother said, you're the only one who can go to Vegas with me and only go to the shows. You can't gamble. You can't drink. You can't do anything else. So we did the Star Trek experience and watched the Queen musical. And the Star Trek experience was top notch. I think I have my picture taken at on the Enterprise. Actually.
Perfect. Well, apparently there is an actual recreation, an official recreation of the set in Ticonderoga. Somebody who worked on the show had the blueprints and made it happen, and it is a tourist attraction now, and you can go and get your picture taken on the set.
That's super exciting. We're going to Ticonderoga. Because there's two things to do there. shall we go on to the next short?
Yes, surely.
It's written by Marissa Lessman, and I had a great time shooting it. Let's take a look.
Fantastic.
Tinder. Hey.
Hey.
Morning, beautiful. Did you have fun last night?
Yeah. Really did. I'm gonna be late for my flight if I don't just grab my shoes and pack up now.
Flight?
Yeah. Did I tell you I'm going to Russia today? Or a teacher's conference in Moscow. Moscow's in Russia, so. Oh, fuck. Mm.
No, I don't think so.
Oh. Okay. Please don't touch that. Okay, I'm gonna go pee now.
Okay.
I'm coming.
Oh,
what?
God.
Who's coming?
No one. It was
just the hell?
Just the TV. Oh,
that was no TV. That was a person.
No.
That was a man.
No.
I can't wait
to hear this. All ears.
Is this your boyfriend?
No.
Oh my God. Oh, I gotta drop a juice. I gotta go move. Oh, oh my God. Oh my God.
Is that your boyfriend?
Oh God. No.
Huh? I was wrong. It's just a fart.
Oh, good.
Okay, who are these people?
My brother and my dad.
What's up?
And they live here?
No.
I do.
No, no you don't.
Yes, I do.
He doesn't.
Looks like he lives here.
No.
Yeah?
He's just here for a minute.
Yeah, my girlfriend broke my heart. Smashed it like a fucking potato.
He actually broke up with her, but whatever.
She turned my records into chowder.
Her basement flooded during a flood.
She knew it was gonna flood.
She didn't know.
Yeah, she
knew. It was just rain.
I'm very sorry for your loss.
She knew it was gonna flood.
Okay, so are you finished packing, or...
Oh, yes, sorry.
Hey, where you going, kid? Oh, hey, Tommy Meyer. Nice
hello,
to meet you.
Hello.
Sorry about that, when nature calls, right?
I understand. I poop sometimes, too.
Yeah, who are you?
Danny. I'm Danny.
Nice to meet you.
You wash your hands on
me. Yeah.
Oh, man.
So, you guys a thing?
No.
Yes.
No, it's just like, we're just like friends. And... Oh, gross, dude.
So, do you, time's your flight?
Flight?
Yeah. Dad, I'm going to Moscow, remember?
What?
Yeah.
What the hell are you going to do in Russia?
I'm going for that conference.
Do you need a ride? I have a bike. Yeah. I can, you have roller skates, I can just drag you.
Oh, no, thank you. That's okay.
You can run next to me?
No, thanks.
You sure?
Yeah, are you ready to go? Because I'm leaving the country.
Ready to go, Joe.
Bye. Bye.
That's all you're taking?
Yep, just the backpack. Travel light, you know?
Want to say goodbye to your brother and your dad?
Yeah, don't forget to say goodbye to us.
Bye.
See ya.
Bye, P. I'll see you in 6 weeks, okay?
Okay.
Dad, try not to clog anything.
Mm-hmm. Be good, honey.
See ya.
Okay, thanks.
Passport. Got your passport?
Yes.
I didn't see a packet, so.
Oh, I got it.
You sure?
Oops.
Gentlemen, as they say in Taiwan.
Oh, that's good. Good job. Mm-hmm.
Have a good one.
Thanks.
All right, bye, guys.
Wow.
Okay,
that is crazy.
Well, yeah, jeez. So crazy. Okay, well, ride safe.
Oh!
Get going.
You don't gotta tell me that. Yeah. I will.
Okay, good.
Ride like thunder.
Uh-huh.
Hug it out?
Kiss? Hug is fine.
Okay.
Let's just do that. It's good. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Oh, thanks.
Wonderful.
Thank you.
So, my love, the next time you're in town, you let me know, because I want to take you to that tapas place. You will love it.
Mm-hmm.
You will be on tapas the world.
Oh, okay. Sure
yeah.
thing.
That's so, the name of the place. Yeah, much as saying that phrase.
Okay.
Okay.
Let's.
Okay. Shall we?
Okay. Should you? Oh, you.
Okay. After you, my love. Change of life action.
Yeah.
Sunny.
Say my name, I'll be your friend. For each unapologetic scent, I'll power through and give to you whatever you want. I'm a wall and I will be your accidental alkalinity. Wrapped around your knees to set you free. I'm just a
nice.
Yeah.
There's nothing like a date where two people are definitely on the same page about what's going on.
I know, right? I believe that was that short was made as like a selling short to be able to sell in LA for a script. I'm trying to think of the right word. Like a selling short is the stupidest thing. It's one of the stupider phrases I've said.
It's not just a short, especially it's a selling short.
It's a selling short, it's especially for this kind of a show.
The kind of thing where you shop it around, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Something like, to that effect.
Exactly. So that was a lot of fun to do. I like watching that. Every time I watch that, there's so many little lines that just kills me.
Yeah. Like everything that guy said, I just like, ah. just throwing up inside a little bit.
He chewed it up.
Oh,
that
yeah.
Guy Micah chewed it up.
Oh, yeah.
I do have to bring up this comment right here from from Bones regarding...
About the first video.
About kind the first of. Video. So here's the deal with that is I did a screening where we showed Captain's Chair and a rather popular filmmaker did the Q&A for the show. And after he asked, he was like, so mansplaining Star Trek, huh? And I was like, cool way to start.
Yeah, that's a good way to put this. You on the spot.
Not what I was going for, but I guess I'll take it. I don't know. So not my intention, Bones. No, not my intention to mansplain Star Trek. I just am a fan. I'm just a fan.
Sometimes a fan is just a fan, right?
Sometimes. All right. And now, I realize, we're talking about Christian's arc and stuff. Luke's arc from those works and Break, which everyone should watch Break. It's still really inexpensive and available on Amazon Prime. Went from that to Winnie and Charlotte, which you tell me what you think of this short.
I've seen this one before, so I'm looking forward to the second viewing of it. And I saw it when it was still available on Amazon. So that's
this is one of the movies that Kevin Smith shouted out, which
yes,
I thought was very, very cool. One
All
of
right.
the cooler things.
You ready, for this?
Let's do this thing.
Here we go. Thank you.
last call.
All right. But this is, like, last call.
You're cutting me off?
Nah, we should stay alert.
Oh, I'll be alert in the morning. I gotta get drunk for this. Are you practicing again?
Darling, we need all the help we can get. We need a dreidel is what we need.
A dreidel?
A dreidel.
Remember Martha? With the beret?
Mm-hmm. She always brought her own glass.
I don't think I ever charged her for a single drink.
Perhaps that's why we find ourselves in this predicament. Neither did I.
Touché.
But the worst one was Whiskey Root Beer. Remember? Whiskey Root Beer. And he shit his pants and shook the turd down the bottom of his leg.
I'm Whiskey Root Beer.
Whiskey Root Beer. Easily one of our messier customers. I used to give that guy free drinks too.
We can't do that. It was a once upon a drunken dream.
Still. I didn't think it would go down like this.
It's the only way. Please don't do this. Not tonight.
We're just too fucking young to beat this shit out of it.
You know the plan. Stick to it.
I'll do whatever you want.
What do you want?
I want to take care of you.
This is how we do it. This is how we survive. I love you.
I believe you.
You trust me?
More than I should.
Thank you.
All right, so that one you really have to go watch again, because there's I may have uploaded the wrong cut, but it's okay because it's still very close. So I apologize to Luke. Definitely go check that again, and I'll show the short again. But that's
it's your show.
I love it. I love that show. I love that short.
How in the world could you guys have burned down that place if you were that drunk?
It works that way.
Yeah. I like how it's right in the middle of a movie. Like it could be a longer piece on either way. On
I agree. I'm trying to get him to write a longer one.
It's like your shop script.
What?
Isn't that what you said after the last film? It's your selling short.
Selling short.
That's why.
The other thing about that short is our guest next week, Erica Wester, did the animation for that short.
I like it. It was very simple but effective.
Yeah, I'm a big, big fan. So yeah. Definitely go find Winnie and Charlotte's Last Night at the Oasis. The movie is very, very close to me for so many different reasons. And so that's the BBF work. That's Luke's work. Pretty pleased with that. And should we go on to
Let's get right into it.
So I'm excited about this. This first one is one of my very favorite shorts of all time. I think it's hysterical. Let me know what you think.
Which one's this one?
Oh, Outer Zone. Well, this is Letters Home from the Outer Zone.
And here we go.
Dear Mom and Mom's friend Keith, at first, I was kind of bummed that you weren't going to send me to the real space adventure camp. But the one Keith found in the back of his old car magazine has been great! I was all kinds of scared when you dropped me off at the strip mall parking lot. But after our Space Leader revealed himself in an awesome display of science and space excitement, I calmed down a bit and started to enjoy the thrills of the journey. His name's Zip Zapson, and he's wonderful. Getting to Astro Training Base Station was the easiest part, thanks to Admiral Zapson's Space Shuttle Warp Jumper. Away we went to shake hands with Milky Ways and Cosmo Dust. Whew! Dang! I didn't know there was so much getting ready to do before I could actually travel into space. The first day, Mayor Zapson prepared my body for the rigors of the cold, dark coffin we call the universe. Next, we adapted my lungs to handle all kind of lunar germs and alien breath. Ugh. Weightlessness and agility training were tiring, but a lot of fun. Coach Zapson says, on the moon we weigh 1/16th of what we weigh on Earth. That means you wouldn't have to sneak extra pudding cups after dinner, Ma. You can eat as many as you want. An astronaut needs more than just physical prowess to make the space grade. He also needs mental toughness. Strategy, cunning, and even diplomacy can sometimes be your best weapon when dealing with interstellar strangers. With my training complete, we headed out to the blast zone for our big launch. I was so excited, I almost ralphed. But I didn't. Must be my training. Zip told me that even at ultralight speed, the journey would still take hours. But he let me in on an ancient astronaut secret and prepared a special hibernation cocktail so the journey would only feel like minutes. I could feel it take effect almost immediately. It was time. I quickly climbed into the cockpit, with Comrade Zapson wishing me a patriot's farewell. I was scared, confused, hungry, sweaty, sleepy. I felt everything I've ever felt before, and some new stuff too. With the control panels flashing lights and the rocket shaking as my lunar lullaby, I drifted away into the way out place. I awoke. Ship's thrusters were silent. How long had it been since I entered Astronap? Wait a minute. The answer will come to me. Had I grown a beard? I had not. It was time for me to exit my steel home and greet the new world I would call Brian's Mars. Cool. I don't know if it was space madness or the Cosmo Bends, but this new planet, it looked a lot like our own. Something was off, though. I surveyed my new surroundings and noticed something moving in the distance. It was an alien! I moved closer for recognizance. The creature moved and gyrated in a sickening dance. I was recording my observation when the beast noticed me. Its face! What kind of madness was this? It had taken the form of my old mentor, Baron Zapson! Must be some sort of lunar camouflage. He probed my brain and disguised himself as someone I trusted. Clever girl. Still in shock, the creature took to its hinds and leapt at me. My training kicked in and I moved without thinking. I attacked back. The beast begged and pleaded for me to abandon my defense. More tricks, I shouted! And with one final blow, I laid him to rest. High on adrenaline, I fell backwards and pulled myself together. Sleep now, my first galactic foe. You know who would love this? Zip! I'll bring him proof of my conquest. A trophy I shall take. This pelt should do. Since that first encounter, Mars has been pretty quiet. But I mustn't let my guard down. She's a wicked siren that waits for my weakness. So I stay alert, awaiting my next transmission from Postmaster Zapson. My ship may be out of fuel, but my spirit is not. So until my next letter, this is Cadet Brian saying, "Abeep, bop, boop, bop, boop." That's Martian for, "I love you, Mom."
It's just genuinely one of the most dime store things I've ever seen in my life.
I love that. That's so much fun because it's hilarious and incredibly sad at the same time.
It's right up our alley.
It's really sad the more I watch the ending sequence.
I love it. It's so, it really
is
creative.
A guy.
It's one of my favorites. Yeah, but what was that guy up to? There's so many questions.
So many ethics at stake.
It really, that is very Christian. That is my friendship with Christian. It's one of the best examples of his work. And this, and what we're about to watch, we're going to end this show on a doozy. This one's really, really good. This is an incredible short.
Before we do, I just have to say that my favorite line from the last one was, "Mayor Zapson prepared me for the long, dark coffin they call the universe."
Brian's Mars.
All right. So this one is Epoxia, right?
Yeah. And this one will be in two parts because technical reasons. So there might be a little blip right in the middle of it, and we'll do our best not to...
We'll find out what happens.
Yeah,
this is all still new world.
But so thanks for watching so far. This one's a little longer, but you'll see it's a beautiful. And the thing, all of these shorts are so Chicago and Illinois. It makes me very much at home. I think they're beautiful, especially I spent almost a decade of my life, around the Winnie and Charlotte corner. Like, that was shot at my movie theater that I worked at forever, and then the bar that everyone went to across the street. That corner was like the center of my universe for a very long time. So it's really fun to watch all these things again. Plus, these guys are my best friends. So what can I say?
Your personal stamp on.
What can I say?
On all these.
So definitely enjoy Hypoxia, and we'll be back afterward.
At the sound of the chime, it'll be the top of the hour. It is currently 62 degrees, but a cold front is moving in from the northeast, so expect to see temperatures in the mid-50s, with lows dipping down to the 40s by the end of the weekend. You're listening to 87.7 WICR. And now, a brief message from the CIBO.
The Crescent Isle Bureau of Organics reminds you that growing or possessing restricted plant life or flowers is a serious offense with serious penalties, including asset seizure and a minimum of 15 years imprisonment. Any purchased flora must be inorganic replicas obtained from a business that displays the proper credentials. If you see anything suspicious, you are legally obligated to report it to the authorities. For your safety and the safety of your fellow citizens, maintain vigilance and cooperate with any CIBO agents.
And now, back to our regular programming.
I need to see the back.
What's with the sniffers?
Same drill every couple of months. Usually in and out. And I get to put this in the window until they trade me for another one.
Doesn't it make you nervous?
Well, if I had anything to grow, it would. But this stuff, it's useless.
I always wondered why you even bothered with it.
Well, it helps sell the illusion. It's kind of like if you went to a museum and nothing was in a frame. It'd feel a little off, even if it took you a while of walking around to realize it.
Yeah, like a dentist with no teeth.
I think you'd catch on to that pretty quick. Did you get that film ready yet?
Working on it.
Oh. See you next time.
You know these things don't die, right?
Well, why did I start that tab for you? Hi, it's me.
Hey, you.
I have bad news.
All right, let's go in three.
One, two.
I can't come.
Unpredictable, huh?
I know, you're just stressed from the inspections.
Look, I'm sorry.
Just, you can tell everyone I wish I could be there.
I will. Can you at least pencil me in for dinner next week?
I'm marking it in ink as we speak.
Right. All right, well, try to relax, and I'll call you tomorrow. All right, I love you.
Love you too.
Last time you went for a swim.
It's been a while. Don't think it'd be a good idea right now, though.
Come on, it's not that bad. It'd be refreshing, like splashing cold water on your face in the morning. And it would turn you a lovely shade of blue.
Well, if you got your way, you could stuff me and put me on your mantle.
Come on, it's not that bad.
It's pretty full.
Where do you think it goes?
Authorities are calling it the largest bust to date under the NEEM initiative. A raid off North Oak Beach turned up the seedlings of 56 banned plants and flowers. The CIBO has been working closely with the Park Service since the initiative took effect, and the growth of their power and expanded jurisdiction has given most citizens an increased sense of security from the dangers of these Class 7F materials, especially in high-volume cases like this, in which they can use the full weight of the law against growers. Prosecutors are seeking the maximum sentencing and expect ruling by the end of the day Friday.
So when they make these busts,
today's headlines.
Does it make it easier for you because they've met their quota, or is it harder because the sniffers are on the prowl?
I'm definitely going to have to cross my T's and dot my I's, which means that I get to look forward to more paperwork and surprise visits.
And does the paperwork have to get done tonight?
It's tonight, or we go to dinner, and it's the only thing I'm thinking about, and that's not fair to you. I'm sorry. Maybe tomorrow night? Edgar!
Hey, I developed the film you gave me. Most of it looks like garbage, I mean, a lot of water damage, but some of them turned out. Sort of.
Thanks.
Margaret, always a pleasure.
Bye, Edgar.
Oh, hello,
hi.
Margaret.
How's it going?
Jonah got you waiting?
He is playing hard to get.
He's a fool.
Hey, do you think you could let me in? I wanted to surprise him, but since he's not here, I figure I really surprise him. And hopefully he'll be hungry.
Ah, a little candlelight dinner.
The whole nine yards.
Say no more. Come on.
I think that I shall never see a poem lovely as the Margaret, what did you do?
I poured myself a glass of wine.
Don't fuck around! Did you call them?
Yes. I called them. Where did you see this going?
I thought...
you were gonna leave me. And you weren't gonna say anything.
I was going to tell you.
Before, when I never saw you, or after. Or should I have just put a message in a bottle and hoped it hit you? You're a criminal!
Jonah, don't do anything stupid.
That was creepy.
Right? I love the world they create in that one. Yeah. I'm a big fan.
Very much. Yeah. It's shot beautifully.
Isn't it? It was shot by a guy named Nick Shamblot.
Very good. Cool dude. Yeah. There were no accidental shots in that movie.
No, they worked really hard on that one. And I'm really pleased that they let us show that one here.
Yeah.
Well,
thank you to that and for all of the filmmakers that we've had this evening. And once again, you can check out all of their films in the regular HD format. You can check them out there on their website, dimestorefilms.com, bbfprods.com. And you can go to jellyrollchicago.com for more information about the show and about what Jake does.
Yeah.
And again, you can still watch these on Amazon. You just have to pay for them now, which is contrary to what the idea was to begin with when they were put up on Amazon for you to be able to watch for free if you had a Prime subscription. So here,
I'm wondering if I can just change the price to zero, to be perfectly frank with you. I don't know if that's possible. I'm definitely going to move everything down to the 99 cent bin for my own stuff. But
this is definitely some ongoing conversation to have. So I look forward to hearing more about maybe the reasons for it and just kind of what's going to happen going forward. And are there going to be some sort of indie streaming platforms? Who's going to own that? And what's that going to look like?
Right. Jack, do we have a special treat for the end of the show?
We do have a special treat. Just to wrap things up here, we thought we'd hit things on kind of a lighter note. So here is the full version of Slow Jam Girl, the award-winning music video.
This is a slow jam for a slow girl. I was feeling rather blue. My heart was in remiss until the day I met you and my heart was filled with bliss. I'm praying every day that your love will see me through. Girls, and none of my friends are girls, and I only sing my song to a girl, even though you're kind of tall for a girl. And that time we played catch, you threw the ball just like a girl,
just like a girl.
Girl, I just wanna make love to you, girl,
girl.
And I sure hope that you're a girl,
girl.
Cause I'm crazy about you, girl. Some brand new shoes. Girl,
girl,
I would never lie to you, girl.
Girl,
please don't make me cry like a girl.
Girl,
cause I'll just have to fight you like a girl.
Girl,
I wanna testify my love to you.
Somebody wanna come and bust a move, but I ain't gonna have it cause I'm with you. Come on to my place and I'll cook it for you. Would you like to eat a peach or kaboo, would you? Girl, you got a hand, so let me hold it. If you wanna smoke, then I can roll it. I don't care what other guys you've been with, cause I can bust a rhyme like Ludacris. Later we're taking it down to the floor, bumping and grinding and begging for more. Doing it nastier than Jersey Shore. Baby, by morning you know we'll be sore.
Girl, I remember the first time that I ever met you, and I asked myself, have I ever met this girl before? And I answered, no, she's a complete stranger to me, and I never talk to strangers. And it was clear to me that you felt the same way too. When you first looked at me, the way that you said nothing said it all. But sooner or later, I found out we was down with a lot of the same people, and suddenly, strangers wasn't so strange no more.
Girl, wanna hold you in my arms, girl. Girl, could you spare me one your breath, man's girl? Here's $20, girl. Could I borrow $20, girl? I'm gonna put it towards a nice gift for you.
Towards a gift for you.
I'm getting your name on a body tattoo.
Good to me, girl.
Girl,
you's always so giving.
Girl,
and so loving.
Girl,
whoa, hold on now, girl.
Girl,
hold on now, girl. Don't go giving away all your love to everybody.
Girl,
slow down a minute, girl.
Wow, Jack.
Thank you.
Are you working on it? Sorry.
I just want to say a very big thank you to my cinematographer, Max Resnick, for shooting that video.
Oh, Mr. Max, Moob.
Mr. Moob.
I was going to ask.
Max shot the whole thing.
That's great.
Everywhere that I was, he was right there with me holding up the camera. So got to say thank you to that. That's wonderful.
It's a family affair.
It really is. Yeah, we shot it over the course of 2 days, Max and I, and it was a lot of fun, and it was really special getting to do that project.
It just reeks of X Theater. It reeks of every single thing that we did.
Reeks of something.
Everything that we laughed at for the last 20 years.
Thank you, Amber.
Yeesh.
Need ice for that burn.
Do you have any? Are there new songs coming? New videos coming?
There are new songs coming. There have been a couple of fun experimental videos. This was kind of a guerrilla filmmaking effort, but since then there have been a couple of music videos that I've done for Amber Live, actually. In the fall, she has the Leaf Peepin' Cider Sippin' Review, and I did a version of Autumn Leaves, and for the winter show, for a Christmas show, I did a version of, what the hell did I do? The Mariah Carey one, the popular one.
Oh, naturally.
All the kids love it.
Yeah, it's a good song.
That one I did just as an instrumental, but I'm playing all the instruments on all these. The weird thing is, for this one, for Slow Jam Girl, I wrote out all the music in GarageBand, but I never picked up an instrument to play it. I played my guitar just when I was figuring out the chords and writing it down on paper, but when it came to time to do all of the music, it was all just done, you know, note by note in the sheet music in GarageBand.
You're a regular dead mouse.
Something like that. Dead something. Reeks of dead mouse, dead mice up in my studio.
Dead
but
mouse
for the other
one,
but for the other ones, for the Mariah Carey, All I Want for Christmas Is You. That's the name of that song. Yeah. And the other one, Autumn Leaves, I'm playing all the instruments. So I'm playing the guitar and the bass and electric guitar and all that fun stuff. So that's up there. And I got to say, you know, just to toot my own horn for that version of the Mariah Carey song, no one has ever done a version of it like that. It's kind of slowed down and dragged out. So
great.
Maybe that's why.
Maybe we'll watch it on a future episode.
Yeah.
Jack, thanks for watching these. Oh, Rusty Peen.
Rusty Peen. Oh,
naturally.
There are. The world has not seen the last of Rusty Peen.
Check out Amber. All right.
Tune into Amber Live on Sunday nights on Facebook, YouTube, and Twitch. Yeah. This has been a fun film festival.
Thanks for watching all these shorts with me.
Yeah.
I haven't done a short series in a while. I just got a Facebook memory about my first screening like 8 years ago or something like that, and I think it's pretty cool that now it's taken on this virtual way of doing it. You can't stop this venue. We're doing all these. Hey,
you can't
thanks.
Keep a good dog down.
You can't keep a good dog down. No.
Wow.
Well, we are running real long, so let's wrap this up. Next week we have animator Erica Wester, and I am very, very excited to talk to her again. She's
love
the one
animation
who did,
here.
Yeah, she's the one who did the animation for Winnie and Charlotte.
Winnie and Charlotte, right.
We'll get to the bottom of things, and she lives out there on the West Coast, so we have some interesting things to talk about.
Final question, what are you watching this week? Or what were you watching this week that you recommend?
Noah. Darren Aronofsky's Noah?
I still haven't seen that one. Oh, man.
Is not great, but everything else is ooh,
it looked
charred.
Awful.
No, it's great. It's Darren Aronofsky. You're wrong. It's wonderful.
He's definitely not a voyeur.
I haven't seen Mother. I don't know what to say about that. But I really enjoyed that. And then you know what? I rewatched The Revenant this morning because I woke up at 5:30 and I was like, I need a quieter movie. Which surprisingly, considering all the gunshots and bear growling and stuff, it's there's a lot of nature and snow and rivers and stuff
got
like
it.
That.
It has
so,
that just waking up sort of feel, like get off my property.
Yeah, except then a bear just eats Leonardo DiCaprio and he just fucks him up. It's so good. It won an Oscar for just getting fucked up by a bear. Oh, we got some comments before we
oh yeah, what else we got? Oh,
thank you, Bones. Thank you. Isn't hypoxia good?
Yeah, and hypoxia, that's girl, a trip.
Isn't slow jam girl good?
Isn't it?
I'm ready for the sequel. I'm ready for the next one.
Right on.
I'm ready for your Albuquerque, Jack. When are you going to give me your Albuquerque?
The world is not yet ready for my Albuquerque.
You know I am. Very much so. I want your 12-minute story about sauerkraut.
Jim Steinman just died. The guy who wrote all the Meatloaf songs. Speaking of 12 minutes, my head went to, I would do anything for love, but I won't do that.
Naturally.
Just long ballads. Anyway, I watched Ma Rainey's Black Bottom this week, and if you haven't seen that, that was awesome. Yeah.
I haven't caught it yet. It's great.
Oh, man. Yeah. Chadwick Boseman really tore it up in that.
Wonderful. And
Viola Davis is just, you know, a force to be reckoned with.
We'll have to talk about the Oscars next week. We didn't get a chance to do that.
Kind of bizarre.
Well, I'll be honest with you. The exact same people who are nominated for Oscars were nominated for the Independent Spirit Awards. Like the exact same people. And I'm like, this is interesting. So there is connection. There is reason for us to talk about the Oscars, I guess.
Well, more about that next time. And if you like the show, you can always kick us a tip at Venmo Jelly Roll Chicago.
Thank you guys.
Next week. This has been the epicenter of independent cinema.
I just think they're neat. Kids, turn off the TV. Always with the smooth talk. Your Uncle Arthur used to have a saying, shoot them all and let God sort them out. I just think they're neat, honey. You should listen to your heart and not the voices in your head, like a certain uncle did one gray December morn. At times like this, I guess all you can do is laugh. Now let's forget our troubles with a big bowl of strawberry ice cream. I just think they're neat.